Hello everyone and welcome back to our YouTube channel. My name is Alexandra and today we have yet again your daily twin flame oracle card reading. Let's see what guidance you need on your twin flame journey today. Yes, it's a beautiful day. It's another beautiful day, so let's see what the cards have to tell you. And for today I'm using the Saints and Angels Oracle deck, and yeah, I just felt towards this one. I felt a little bit like more peaceful vibes, so I just wanted to use this deck. Yeah, so let's see what's the first card for us today. And the first card, we got this card in a previous reading. I think it was the Romanian reading, but the card is marriage. So yeah, it's all about that marriage. So congratulations, this means marriage is all about deepening your commitment with yourself and your twin flame, right? And it's a really beautiful thing. Like I'm married with Laurent, you, and you know, it's something else fully and completely when you dedicate yourself, you know, completely towards your twin flame, right? And I know, like, we are doing this a lot, like, as we, you know, go deeper on our twin flame journey. But yeah, I feel like this is kind of like the message for you, to just dedicate yourself fully and completely towards your twin flame journey and recognize that yes, you can have everything that you desire here with your twin flame, this perfect relationship. And you may also heal through things related to marriage. And I feel like, while, you know, we all desire to marry our twin flames, there are definitely a lot of maybe wounds or, you know, bad feelings about marriage itself. And it's safe to look there, right? And see what doesn't feel good about getting married. Because while we do want to manifest our twin flame marriage, you know, it's the most beautiful thing, we do have to do this by getting into the parts that feel uncomfortable about marriage, and see what's there for you, right? Maybe you have been in a very committed relationship, or even married before, right? So, or you have seen like marriages around you, how they are, and you don't feel like you want that, right? And it's true, like your twin flame marriage is not like that. It's not like what you have experienced before. It's something new entirely. It's very beautiful. It's very beautiful, but you have to cultivate that within yourself and to give yourself that beautiful marriage that you desire with your one true love. And yeah, marriage is a place in consciousness that's heard right now. You know, people are divorcing and, you know, they're getting married, and you don't really know like how the relationship is going to be like. Well, when you are marrying with your twin flame, you know that you're gonna always go deeper and deeper with love, and you're never gonna divorce or break apart, because that's not how it works with twin flames, right? So just allow yourself to feel through everything that's coming up here related to your twin flame journey, and especially about, you know, like marriage and commitment, and allow yourself to go deeper there, because you will unlock, you know, greater heights of love between you and your twin flame when you commit deeper to yourself and your relationship with yourself and with God. And see what's stopping you from doing that. It's always safe to deepen your relationship with yourself and God. So there are some lies there that maybe you are releasing right now about what that actually means, right? So yeah, just enjoy that juicy feeling and heal through everything that comes up about this subject, you know, because you know, commitment is something that we like, it's a, I want to say like a big block, you know, twin flame is not talking with me and they don't want to be with me and na na na. It's a big block that's going on. So therefore, it's okay to look at that and heal through that and see where are you not committed to yourself, where you don't want to be with yourself fully and completely, where you don't want to have this perfect marriage in a way with yourself and with God. And I if you do this and you really sit with it, you really are going to experience a deepening in your twin flame relationship, and ultimately you are going to manifest this. It's guaranteed and you are going to manifest this. Good. The next card is Healthful Eating, right? Yes, and I feel like with this it's all about healing, you know, in your external reality, in your relationship with food. Of course, this is about, the card is healthful eating, right? So your relationship with food, and ultimately it's your relationship with body. And I don't know why, like, I felt like a romance coming up right now. So yeah, just see how you can romance yourself through food. You're going to experience, you know, a greater joy and love in your food when you are going to fully and completely just surrender, right? The you know, surrender into more love and joy in the food itself, right? And this is something that I'm going deeper with right now, and it's a very helpful card in a way, because it's just going to, yeah, help. It's helping me, you know, ground my twin flame union, harmonious union, our marriage, everything. And when you are enjoying like food with your twin flame, you can always go deeper into love. Good. So yeah, just enjoy food here, enjoy life in your food, right? And how is this going to help you? How is this going to help you in your twin flame journey? Is by simply bringing that joy and love right now into this area of your life, and ultimately you'll be able to experience, you know, where do you like to go on a date? You know, when you go on a date, just think about it. Are you gonna enjoy food on that date? Yes. So therefore, most probably, right, you're gonna go to a restaurant, you're gonna go maybe to a movie and you have some snacks, right? So it's really important to look at this relationship with food and romance yourself through the food that you are eating right now. And I feel like this is the message for you today about healthful eating, right? Romance yourself through food. And yeah, just have like little date nights with yourself, in which you eat something that you really like, you know, like how you would go on a date, you know, maybe buy a, you know, get yourself a piece of cake or something that you really enjoy, so you can increase that romance in your eating, right? And healthful eating is not just about eating what is considered to be healthy, but it's eating in such a way that you are happy, right? Good. So the last card for us today is it's peaceful. So yeah, focus on the peace on your twin flame journey. Focus on achieving the next level of peace and being peaceful, right? When you are peaceful on your twin flame journey, you're doing it right, really. And nothing can stop you from being with your twin flame when you are peaceful. And enjoy that peace and grow that peace and nurture that peace. And as you do that, the attraction between you and your twin flame will increase dramatically, and you will be reunited if you choose that, right? So choose to be with your twin flame, and in that place of peace, you will always find them. You'll always find your twin flame in love, and you will always experience deeper and deeper love with your twin flame in this space of peace. And it's not going to happen in excitement, it's not going to happen in, of course, fear or anxiety or control. It's only going to happen when you are peaceful and you are cultivating this peace with yourself. So therefore you are, you're just growing and deepening this relationship through peace. And this is the key on your twin flame journey. It's peace, it's love that's going to bring you and your twin flame together. And you have to be willing to see where you are not peaceful. You know, your twin flame will mirror that, where you are not peaceful. And look at that and just heal it. Do the mirror exercise and you will achieve, you know, this peace and this love in a deeper and deeper way. Good. And with that being said, this is our reading for today. I hope you enjoyed it. It was a really beautiful reading. And we will see you in the next video. And until then, don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you.